Hi, Paul Aubin here, and today I'd like to talk to you about slope arrows. I've got this simple chapel space here on screen, and it's a square footprint in plan, and I want to do something kind of interesting with the roof, so I want to try a few variations. Now, when you use a standard footprint roof in Revit, and you use the slope-defining edge feature, which is what I've done for this really simple hip roof right here. I'm going to go to Edit Footprint. You get a slope that passes through each of these edges. So another way to think of that is these edges become essentially piano hinges. Now, if you're trying to create one of the traditional forms of roof, hip or gable, then that's a perfectly fine way to do it. But what do you do if you want your slope to be something a little bit more unusual? What if I don't want my slope to follow one of those edges? Well, that's when I can use a slope arrow. So what I'm going to do in this case is I'm going to select these four edges, and I'm going to turn off the defined slope. Now, if I were to click finish right now, I'd get a totally flat roof. Now, that's not really what I'm after, so let's continue by adding a slope arrow. So up here on the ribbon, I'm going to click the slope arrow tool, and you just simply pick two points to define the arrow. The first click is the tail of the arrow, and the second click is the head. Now, you can tell the difference because, of course, the head will have a little arrowhead on there. There is a rule here. The head of the arrow can be anywhere you like. It could be floating out here in space. The tail, however, must stay on a sketch line. Now, it could be at the corner, like I drew it a moment ago, or it can be anywhere along this edge, but it can't be out here in space like you see it right now. So I'm going to undo those two grip edits there. So what I'm doing is saying I want the slope to follow along this slope arrow. In other words, I want the slope to go along the diagonal of the square rather than running perpendicular to one of its edges, like I would get if I did slope edges. Now, you can select the arrow, and over here on the properties palette, you can modify the slope. Now, there's two ways you can do that. You can specify the height at the tail and the head, or you can define slope. In this case, I'm going to specify the heights. So here, for the offset at head, I'm going to change that to 20 feet. I'm going to leave the offset at tail set to 0. So this is my low point at 0, and this is going to be my high point at 20 feet. When I click finish, you'll see that I now get a roof that looks something like that. It's still pretty much a flat slab, but that flat slab slopes along its diagonal now instead of along one of its edges. Now, we could make this even a little bit more interesting by introducing additional slope arrows. So I'm going to edit the footprint again, draw another slope arrow. And this time I'll go from the opposite diagonal and I'm going to snap right to the midpoint of that existing line. I'll do one more, also to that midpoint. And then I only wanted this line here to give me those midpoints, so now I can delete that. And I'm going to select these two new arrows that I've created and I'll set the offset there to 20 feet like I did in the previous one. And let's click finish and see what that gives me. So now I get a ridge along the top because I have a low point at both of the opposite corners and they're both sloping up to that 20-foot height here in the middle. So the more slope arrows you begin to introduce, the more interesting it can become, but it can also get a little bit more complicated too. So you have to think it through carefully to make sure that you get the result that you're after. Thanks for watching.